student. I am Neeraj. In previous session, we learned polynomial, degree of polynomial, zeros of polynomial, and type of polynomial. In this session, we are going to learn relation between zeros and coefficient of quadratic polynomials. Let's go to learn. We know that quadratic polynomial has two zeros. So here alpha and beta are zeros of quadratic polynomial. Let the alpha and beta be the zeros of the quadratic polynomial. So px is equal to ax square plus bx plus c, where a doesn't equal to 0. Then x minus alpha and x minus beta will be factor of px. Hence ax square plus bx plus c is equal to k x minus alpha into x minus beta, where k is constant, minus k into alpha plus beta x plus k alpha beta. On comparing the coefficient of x square, x and constant term on both sides, then we get k is equal to a minus k into alpha plus beta is equal to b, and k alpha beta is equal to c. When we put value of k in equation second, we get minus a into alpha plus beta is equal to b. Hence alpha plus beta is equal to b by minus a. And when we put the value of k in equation third, we get a alpha beta is equal to c. Alpha beta is equal to c by a. Alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, and alpha beta is equal to c by a. Here alpha and beta are zeros of quadratic polynomial, and b is coefficient of x and a is coefficient of x square. So we said that sum of zeros is equal to minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x square, and product of zeros is equal to constant term by coefficient of x square. These are relationship between zeros and coefficient. Now we learn relation between the zeros and coefficient of cubic polynomial. We know that cubic polynomial has three zeros. So let alpha, beta and gamma be the zeros of cubic polynomial. And general form of cubic polynomial is
ax cube
plus bx square plus cx plus d, where a doesn't equal to 0. Here alpha, beta and gamma are zeros of cubic polynomial, then x minus alpha comma x minus beta and x minus gamma will be the factor of px. Hence ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d is equal to k x minus alpha into k x minus beta into x minus gamma, where k is constant. When we solve expression, we get kx cube minus k alpha plus beta plus gamma x square plus k alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha x minus alpha beta gamma
k.
On comparing the coefficient of x cube, x square, x and constant terms on both sides, we get k is equal to a, equation number first, minus k into alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to b, k into alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha is equal to c, minus k alpha beta gamma is equal to d, question number 4.
When we put
value of k in equation second, we get minus a into alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to b, hence alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to minus b by a. When we put value of k in equation third, we get alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha is equal to c by a. And when we put value of k in equation fourth, then we get alpha beta gamma is equal to minus d by a. So we said that sum of zeros is equal to minus coefficient of x squared by coefficient of x cubed. Sum of the product of zeros taken to at a time is equal to coefficient of x by coefficient of x cube, and product of zero is equal to minus constant term by coefficient of x cube. These are relation between zeros and coefficient of cubic polynomial.